Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how I get ready for a night out. So me and two of my girlfriends are going to go and see Drake tonight. We are really, really excited and yeah, I need to get ready. So it's a rare occasion that I get to go out. So when I do get ready, I find it really, really fun. Surprisingly, I actually don't take too long to get ready, and even though this makeup isn't as dramatic as I usually wear, it is super glam for photos and it just looks beautiful. It wears really, really well throughout the night. I've not actually used this foundation many times before, but whenever I do use it, it's when I'm going out, and my foundation always seems to last pretty long. So to get ready, I'm going to show you guys my tan, kind of. There's a little bit of me after I've put my tan on. I'm going to take you with me to the hair salon. I'm going to my friend Jasmine's hair salon called Blonde, which is in Glasgow's south side. We've been friends for years now, and she's actually coming with me tonight. So she said she would do my hair for me, which is amazing. So we're going to go there, come home, do our makeup, and then get changed as well. It doesn't look like I'm wearing that much, which is kind of true. Really nice just to sit down and get ready with you guys, and now I get to go and enjoy some Drake with my gals and some wines, and it's going to be great. If you'd like to see how to get ready with me, stay tuned. Hello, so I've put my fake tan on. I use U-Tan Turbo Tan. It's great. It's my favourite fake tan of all time. It's really, really fab. So I've used that all over my body. I've had it on for about 3.5 hours because I couldn't be bothered doing it last night. So I'm going to go and shower this off, and then we're going to Blonde, which is my friend Jasmine's salon, where she does hair. She's amazing. She's so good. She's been one of my friends for so long now. We met when I first started in Onyx, so that was pretty, like, years ago now. And yeah, she's going to do me a slick Rick hairdo, and then when we get back, we're going to do her makeup, and then I'm going to show you what I'm wearing. But yeah, I did my fake tan, and I'm feeling so much better. Baby, I like your stuff. Hi! I think this is my favourite thing in the entire world. My hair did, and now we need to go home and do my makeup ASAP because we don't have much time before we need to be there. So guys, I'm just going to jump right in because I look like a maniac. I've just got my hair done. I took you with me. We went to Jasmine. She slicked me and gave me a little curl. I like it. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to prepare my skin. I'm going to use the Charlotte Tilbury Wonder Glow. Love this. And obviously, if you haven't noticed, I am the most tanned person ever. I used my Turbo Tan from U-Tan and Tone. I'll link them down below. And I just did it this morning. It makes me really nice and tanned. It's not orangey at all. I only had this on for like 4 hours this morning, maybe actually 3.5. Actually, yeah, I only had this on for about 3 hours this morning, and it gave me such a nice colour. And then I went and got my hair done, and now we're doing our makeup because we're gonna see Drake tonight. 10 bands, 50 bands, 100 bands. It's gonna be really good. So I had to dig deep into my boxes and boxes of makeup because we are moving soon, and I had to get a foundation. And I don't even know if it's gonna match me, because I am really tanned. So this is the Hourglass Vanish Stick in the shade Golden. Yeah, that'll do. It's going to be a wee bit light for me, but we're going to make it work. I've not actually used this that much because it doesn't suit me when I'm pale and it's been winter, so I'll be cracking it out a wee bit more now that we're getting into the spring months, and I fully intend on keeping this tan up. So let's try and blend this in. We'll see what happens. Magic Complexion. Let's use the Charlotte Tilbury Magic Complexion brush. Ooh. That's a good colour. So the colour that I've used is Golden. So it's funny, when I usually... it's a wee bit dry looking. I just use a little bit of my Pure Miracle Mist to try and get it moving a bit better, because it's quite dry. I don't know whether it's because I've got fake tan on though. Yeah, okay, that's fine. So when I go out, I usually get ready quite quickly, and that's what I'm doing here. This is a get ready with me. So I'm just going to get ready. See, this brush is shedding quite a lot. Putting you back. I'm going to go back to my Smith 112 brush. That's my favourite. And if you're wondering why I'm not using a beauty blender, they're all broken. They all broke, so I had to put them all in the bin. We tan. I wish I was this tanned naturally. Now I'm going to go in with my Shape Tape, and I'm actually going to use the colour Medium. Am I? Yeah. Because I want to keep the tan look, you know? I don't want it to be far too ashy under my eyes.
And like I said, I get ready like rapid fire, and I'm going to have quite a lot of this because I'm going out tonight. I wear quite a lot of makeup all the time, but I do definitely wear a little bit more when I'm going out. I'm going out. So perfect. I love this concealer. I've already put a little bit of Shape Tape over my eyelids and set it, and I've done my brows already as well using the Charlotte Tilbury Legendary Brow because time is of the essence. Now I'm going to go in with the Charlotte Tilbury Airbrush Flawless Finish Powder, and I use the shade 2 Medium, which should be perfect actually for me today. And I'm going to set under my eyes, around the sides of my mouth, my chinny chin chin, and then my forehead. I would use my Rimmel Loose Powder, but I don't use too much powder when I'm going out. Now we're going to go straight into the bronzer, and I'm going to use my good old favourite MAC Dark Tan, and it's the Mineralize Skin Finish, and we're just going to start to bronze up our cheekbones. And because I'm so tan, this stuff looks perfect. And I'm just using my Charlotte Tilbury Powder and Sculpt brush with the Dark Tan, and I'm just carving out the cheekbones a little bit, and then I'm going to do the usual round the jawline. I just like it when I'm really tan like this, my eyes look lighter. This is not my mug, this is Jack's mug. Okay, now I'm going to dip into my NYX Love Contours All palette. I did a tutorial using this entire palette, but I'm actually just going to go into this really dark contour shade here. Just add that depth right at the back, you know. Now I'm going to go back in with the MAC Dark Tan, and I'm going to scoop the nose like a little ball of ice cream. See the difference that makes. Now I'm super bronzed, I'm going to go in with my highlight. This is really backwards, but when I'm going out, this is how I do my makeup. I literally just go whack it on. So I'm going to go in with my Becca Opal, my fave, and just bless the cheekbones. I hope Drake doesn't mind it when his lights like bounce off my face and I put him off his whole game. It's going to be pretty embarrassing. Being tan's worth it for this alone. You already know that the Tin Man nose is coming back. So like a little exclamation mark. So you go down the bridge and then boop. And then I'm just going to go back round the nose with the bronzer. And I'm actually going to use blusher today because I'm so tanned. I'm going to use Risqué by Tarte. And that is like my perfect going out skin. Super glowy. It's just my fave. So for the eyes, I'm going to use my Melt eyeshadows. I love these. I know that they're not the easiest to get, but hopefully the guys over at Melt are going to work on that. And the colours I'm going to use, let's see. Definitely that one. Meh. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take the colour Unseen. You can clearly see it's loved by me. And we're going to start blending this in the crease. I'm going to zoom you in a little bit. I'm going to pop this in the crease. And I'm just using my Smith 232 brush to build that up. Same as usual, using window wiper movements. Obviously, this is the lightest colour that we'll be using in the transition shade of things. So it's really, really easy to get it nice and blown out. You don't need to worry too much about how much product you're putting on and all that. And then I'm actually going to go underneath my eye with the same colour and the same brush as well. And I do need a little mirror. And all that's going to do is it's going to set under the eye a little bit more. And it's a little bit darker than our eye as well, so it's just going to smoke it out underneath without being too dark. And I'm just blending that on top again. Cool. I'm going to use the shade Rust now, and we're going to pop that under our eye a little bit, just to the outside. Right, and then I'm going to put a little touch of this in the crease, and then I think I'm actually going to leave it like that for the eyes. Do you know that? So I'm building up the crease, bringing that right in to their corner. I've swapped my brush over and I'm using just a little 230 brush, a little bit smaller. Then I'm going to swap back to my bigger brush and go back in with the transition shade, and then we're going to buff that right out. And I'm just going over where we've put the rust colour and I'm just blending that out, making sure my brush is nice and high. Always remember that. Do you know, I actually remember I learned that tip off Crispy flipping years ago and I've just stole it. Thank you for the tip, Crispy. See, now that makes me quite happy. I like how green my eyes look, and I think because I'm so tanned, it's quite nice to keep it this soft and neutral. With a big lash, it'll be nice. It's kind of like if I was doing like a catwalk makeup on, what's her name? You know who I'm talking about, the super tanned, beautiful model. She's like Spanish or maybe Brazilian, but she's stunning and she's got super tan skin and she's always got a really nice matte eye going on. She's my fave. Oh, what's her name? Nagna. Oh, that's gonna really annoy me. I'm gonna go quickly in with the shade Blur and I'm just gonna put that over my lid to stop anything from creasing and to blur the eyeshadow. Now I'm going to pop some mascara on. That's literally what I'm going to leave my eyes like for just now. I'm going to use my Pure Big Look Mascara. Honestly, I've had this for so long and I use it so much that it's getting quite clumpy, but I love it because it builds really, really easily. Bing! Do you know what? I've not used that Hourglass foundation that many times before, but it looks sweet as a nut. It looks fabulous. I'm all about self-love today. Why not? And we just need to do our little baby bottom lashes. Okay, lashes time. Right, I've got no idea what Lindsay's are, but they look so nice and fluffy. They're so fluffy, I'm gonna die. Do you know, I never ever go out, you guys. Hardly ever. I'm so excited because I never get to go out with my friends because they're always, like, honestly, most of my friends either live down in London or are hairstylists or makeup artists, so they're always working. Right, these lashes are quite large, but I think it's going to be amazing. Although, see, in all honesty, this is probably one of the only times I would literally just wear mascara. I think I look so nice. So I'm just using my glue, my dual glue, green one, putting that on the wee lashes, and then I've set them down on the table flat just so they can dry because the curl of the lash usually keeps the band off the table so it doesn't get all gluey and sticky and yucky. So I'm just going to use a little bit of my Cara brow gel from Charlotte Tilbury, the legendary brows, and I'm just going to put that through because it's a nice dark brown colour. Because I usually wait until I've done my powder and stuff to do this step because sometimes powder gets in my brows and that just makes them nice and dark. I love that when you're tanned as well you can get away with having a darker brow. I'm going to be tanned forever now. Okay, now I'm just going to stick this on. So I'm just focusing the lash in the very outer corner. Boo boo! Okay, and now I just really need to squeeze them to the lash line. So I'm going to use my little thing from Tarte that I love. And now all that's really left to do is our lippers. I got an amazing package from Makeup Geek and it's got all their new, they're called Showstopper Cream Stains and it's like a liquid lipstick and I tested it on my hand and it looked amazing. Oh, I just don't know what one though. Maybe Curtsy. Cause I'm a lady tonight. Oh, it's kind of peachy. That could go either really nice or really bad. Yeah, really bad. Okay, I'm gonna try Waltz. Ooh. Smells nice, not overpowering. I'm not sure about this color though. Okay, I'm gonna mix the colors and I'm not doing my lip liner. Yeah, I like the peach colour better. I don't know how I feel about this. Jack, can you come here and let me know what you think of my lipstick?
Nice. Nice and nude.
Do you think I look tanned?
Yeah, very tanned.
Nice.
Settled in well, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's a good one. Jack would never admit this to you guys, but he actually did my back and it's perfect, isn't it? You're so good.
Thanks.
Right, I'm just going to put a wee bit of lip liner on because I feel like my lips are getting a wee bit lost in my face. Can you see the difference in my teeth? Look how much straighter they are already. I've got two wee long teeth now because they need built up a little bit, but I'm happy. Better. I'm using the Iconic Nude from Charlotte Tilbury. This is quite different for me, isn't it, guys? The lipstick looks amazing. It feels a wee bit dry, but at the same time, it feels like nothing. So that might be a good thing. And I'm just going over the lip liner with a wee bit of the lipstick. This one's called Curtsy and this one's called Waltz. So I've used a bit of both, but mostly Curtsy. I love the tube. I think it's really chic. It's kind of like a peach. And then last step, I'm going to use a little bit of my Tarte Fake Awake liner, which goes in the waterline and it just really brightens everything up. I'm going to use that just now. Awake, tired. And then after I do that step, I always kind of go in with a little bit more mascara just because shaky hands and I just got the cream colour all over my lashes. And now I just need to do my freckles. Woo! And that, you guys, is my finished makeup look. I hope you like it. It's like the least Scottish I'll ever look. So you guys, that is the finished makeup look. I'm gonna go and get changed now and then I'll come back and I'll show you what my outfit looks like, and I'm also gonna do a little bit of shining up of the old shoulders and the old boobs. So I'm gonna show you how I kind of contour and shine up my skin to make it look super glowy and glossy for in photos and things like that. So I will be back in 2 minutes. Okay, basically what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna show you how I shine this up. Obviously I've got my tan on, which I love so much, but if I didn't, I would use the Body Blur from Vita Librata. This is in the shade Medium. I wore this when I was in LA last week, so I didn't have tan on, and it was amazing. It made me look super bronzed and polished, and it smooths out your skin really beautifully as well. This tan does the same thing. If you didn't have time for tan, that stuff's great. You just put it on with your hands, and it looks like body makeup. What I am gonna use though is Supermodel Body from Charlotte Tilbury. It is a beautiful product. Pull off the top and it comes in a kind of roller ball. So you spin it to on, you give it a squeeze, and you basically roll it onto your skin and you give it a little blend in. So it just makes you look super shiny. So I'm gonna use it all over my chest. Okay, I just turned it off. There we go. So I'm just gonna use it all over my chest, give it a blend in. Can you see that? It's beautiful. I use it all over my collarbones, on my shoulders as well, and you can use it right over tattoos. Basically, just want to look super shiny, like a supermodel. If I had my legs out, I would put it on all over my legs as well, but I've just got my kind of top half out, so it's looking pretty sheeny. But what I do now is I go in with my Becca Opal, use the brush that I used earlier. This is the Kat Von D Shade and Light brush. I literally just apply the highlight onto the kind of top spots of my shoulders, my collarbones as well, and then when it comes to my boobs, I literally just go right in between them and shine up there. So there you go, now you can see. So I've gone right in between my boobs. I'm going to go just on the kind of fuller part of my boob as well, so it gives them a nice shine. And then I'm going to go in with my bronzer, the dark tan from MAC, plus my Charlotte Tilbury powder and sculpt brush, and I'm just going to bronze the kind of inside here of my boob. See how much rounded this one looks? And that just gives them a nice glow and a nice contour. And then I'm just gonna bring that highlight up here a little bit onto my chest. Nice. And then I'm gonna go back into the bronzer and I just kinda do the awkward pose, and I'm gonna bronze underneath my collarbones and then inside them as well. So see this little kinda hollow part? And then I like to just bronze the line down my neck. I look like I've got man shoulders when I do that. And that just makes everything super sheeny. And that's me pretty much ready, and I got ready really quickly. I only started getting like filming at 4 and now it's 5 to 5, so it's only taken me an hour. Obviously, I had my hair done for me. Thank you, Jasmine. But apart from that, I'm ready. Oh, no I'm not. Can't forget the hoops. Ow! Flipping heck. Oh, and these are my kind of modest hoops, you know, they're not so big, if you know what I'm saying. And that is me ready to go, you guys. I hope you liked this get ready with me. Obviously, I took you to the hair salon. I did my tan earlier. If you're wondering more about my kind of tan routine, I do have a video that's pretty old, but it's quite far back, and it's my tanning routine, and it is using the U-Tan and Tone Tan. The one I recommend is the medium to dark 40 minute turbo tan. It's my favourite. It gives the most flawless bronze. It's so easy to use because I am really, really awful at things like that. And then obviously we did our makeup. I got dressed. If you like this kind of tutorial, please do let me know down below. Obviously I don't go out that much, but when I do, I would love to kind of bring you along with me and show you what I'm doing to get ready. And other than that, I will see you in the next tutorial. Bye!